It's been a while since my last video was uploaded. I have been traveling and seeing how the ecosystem across the globe is being harnessed for the right mandate. Recently, I attended one of the workshops organized by Your Story in Gurgaon in association with WeWorks, and I noted a few pointers, and I believe those are the basic pointers. And India as a country has seen a lot in last 10 years. A last decade has actually changed everything as how businesses are working, especially in the online sector. We have competition law in place right now, and the way I see, a lot of new age laws have to be enacted with the viewpoint to resolve disputes which might happen because of agreement and disagreement. When two parties are signing a contract, though we talk about different clauses, we are not aware about a lot of aspects which might change one's future. Having said that, I'll be talking about a very important clause, which is ESOP. And this was a pointer which was discussed in the Your Story event also. So we are in the technology business. We all know about it. However, there are a few companies which have stood out in the last decade in different sectors. If we talk about the sectors, we have Flipkart, we have Make My Trip, we have Zomato, we have Urban Club, we have Messenger like Hike, which is AI driven. Then we have Swiggy, which claims to be AI driven again, and they have this tagline also. Now, how to retain talent and what is the importance of ESOP pool is very, very important. I would like to highlight few of the most must points which needs to be taken into consideration when a startup is being incorporated, or whether as an entrepreneur or as a business person you're looking for funding opportunities. Before starting any business as an entrepreneur, as a founder, as a co-founder, you need to understand that you need to have clarity of thought. Many a times businesses are started with an intent to solve a problem. However, the question you need to answer to yourself is whether that problem is genuine enough in terms of the kind of pie you're going to target. I learned a very good pointer when I was at the big data event in China. So I was discussing this pointer with a few of my colleagues there, where we discussed about what is the most important factor when we talk about business. And after that discussion, the most important factor which came out in the whole discussion was, who are your customers? I think once you are able to identify the customers, everything becomes very easy. Two types of industry which thrive at any given point of time, whether you are a service industry or your product industry. Now, as a business entrepreneur, once you're able to bridge that gap of understanding and having that clarity of thoughts, you are in a position to even hire the right talent. Now, as an entrepreneur, I'm sure somehow or the other, you would be utilizing some kind of technology to do business. So what is your touchstone is the first question you need to answer. And the best way is to write it down. I think penning down thoughts is very important today, because in the technology era, we use so much of technology. We have iPads, we have whatnot. However, the real diamond is when you start writing with your own hands, because that is when a human is using all the senses. So I have been a big advocate of old school has to marry the new school, and that is when the magic happens. So when we talk about ESOP pool, how much percentage of ESOP pool should be there in the contract? First of all, ESOP pool has to be there in the very first stage, because then at the subsequent stages, if any, for any business model, the dilution would be there. ESOP pool in the Indian ecosystem is somewhere between 12 to 15%. When we talk about US, where the businesses are much more matured because of the kind of funding the startups are getting from the government and the support of VCs, the whole ecosystem is very well developed. So there the ESOP pool percentage is around 10%. Europe is again very matured in terms of there's a very simple concept. When you share the pie becomes larger. And here I would like to share something. I watched one of the videos of Alok Ji. Alok ji is founder of C2W, and why I resonate with Contest to Win is since very early in the 90s, when for the very first time I came online, there were few websites which I was very, very intrigued into. Obviously, gaming is one sector, and Contest to Win had those good buddy system where you call your buddies and then you get merchandise. So it was very early, and I was one of the, I think, very loyal adopters of Contest to Win. Coming back to the point here is, he talked in one of his videos about Dhande Ki Baat, and he talked about the importance of zero, Z. So it was A to Z, and he talked about zero. And I would just like to reiterate and put my pointers into that whole concept, is that when you start your business, you should consider yourself balanced. Zero is like, you know, for me, zero on the timeline is the balance. It's when you are balanced, and even if you read history, magic happens at the, you know, odd hours in terms of 000, when it's like all the cosmic power is working with you. Coming to the point is how to take zero to infinity, in terms of how to take zero to 10x, 100x, or 10 raised to power, infinity x. And if we talk about the mathematics, calculus can be something which can be used in the whole ecosystem. And the point here is very simple: when you hire talent, give them the right tools so that they are able to harness their true potential. And once any talented person is able to harness the true potential, magic happens. And even as a founder, you feel happy when everybody is growing. Growth is not constant. Growth is a non-linear curve, and being part of the non-linear curve is very important. Coming back to the pointer of ESOP, very important must pointer is, when you start a business model, the first thing you need to do is the contract should have an ESOP pool of somewhere between 12 to 15%. The other pointer which was discussed at the Your Story event was by Alok Vajpai. He's the founder of Ixigo. He talked about product to market fit. So when you start a business model, take funding from your friends, family. They are your angel funding partners. Because once people believe in your model, and I think that is where one thing is very important, is who is investing in your business. If the business is being invested by people who have a very good background in terms of the connects or the kind of work they have done in the past, will make it easy for you for the next round of funding. So if you have any questions related to ESOPs, or if you have any questions how to take your business model to the next level, I would be happy to assist. My name is Prity. You can connect with me on LinkedIn. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye. Take care.